Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Toon Dallas. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new, please hit that thumbs up button. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on your notification bell so you can be notified whenever we drop a future tour. All right, guys, so today we are going to visit Philadelphia's third worst neighborhood based on data provided by Google in Philadelphia, PA. We're going to visit the Strawberry Mansion section of Philadelphia, PA. So I figured I'd take you guys with me so we can enter the Strawberry Mansion section together. I'm planning on trying to start off at around 27th and Susquehanna, maybe like 26th and Dolphin. Right now we are on 18th and York. 18th and York, guys. We're passing York. Cleveland and York, 2400 block of Cleveland Street. Right now we're still in North Philly. Oh man, buddy over there is bleeding. I wonder what happened to him. Oh, it looked like somebody cracked him. That's not cool, man. Unless he fell. Oh, he falling down to the ground. Is he all right? Yeah, all the old heads came out to check up on him. I just literally drove by this. Now I don't know what's happening. But let me mind my business, right? So we are going to continue proceeding. We're passing York. We're passing the Bethel Presbyterian Church. We're on York and Garnet Street. We're now passing York and Opal Street, the 2300 block of Opal. We're now passing the 2300 block of 20th Street. We are passing the 2300 block of Wood Street. We are passing 2300 block of Lambert Street. And now we're at the intersection of 21st and York. It's the evening hours. It should be getting dark in about an hour. I believe when I started the tour, it was about 4:30. And nowadays, it gets dark at around 5. No, it's probably less than 4:30. It's probably like closer to 4:10 or so. Okay, we are on the 2300 block of Van Pelt. 2300 block of Van Pelt Street. Is a two-story neighborhood. Okay. We have Glenwood Avenue in front of us. Passing York and Glenwood Avenue. Now, I believe once we pass this corridor right here, I believe this takes us into Strawberry Mansion. Strawberry Mansion section. You would have to go up Glenwood. So if you go up Glenwood, we just passed Glenwood. But if we went up Glenwood and made a right on Dolphin, that should take us into the Strawberry Mansion section of the city. I actually covered this area before several times on the silent tours, but due to popular demand, you guys seem to enjoy hearing my voice. I kind of beg to differ. Quite honestly, I was tired of hearing my voice for many, many, many years. That's why I did my previous hood tours silent. But I have to give the audience what you guys want. If you guys want me to talk, I'm going to do my best to try to provide a little bit of narration. I don't know all facts and all details and all stories about every neighborhood, but I would do my best to acknowledge what I know, and if anything seems obvious, then I'll tell you the obvious. All right, we're gonna make a left right here on Sedgley. So I don't think it was Glenwood that separated the corridor. I think it was Sedgley. We're on Sedgley Avenue. Yeah, we're on Sedgley and 24th Street. Sedgley and 24th, actually, the sun's still up quite a bit. It might even be closer to 4. We'll find out. Once it gets dark, we'll find out what time I left. Because if I left at 4:10, or I started at 4:10, an hour from 4:10 should be 5:10. It should be dark by the time we finish the tour. If it's still light out by the time we finish the tour, then my timing was inaccurate. So, okay, I believe we're going to make a right coming up. I think Dolphin comes up. I think we're gonna hit 24th and Dolphin. On my left hand side, you guys see some type of tower. It's like, I don't know, 2, 3, 4 towers together. Does anybody know what that was? Because I do not. It looks abandoned though. It's been here for years, as long as I can remember. This lot next to me has always been pretty empty. You see the lot on my right? You see how they got those 2x4 wooden gates? Most of the time, those are provided by the city. The city of Philadelphia comes out and frames up certain lots, especially if it's their property. I used to work with a coalition called the Women's Revitalization Project, which they worked with the Land Trust Committee. So I would attend committee meetings where we would have large maps and blueprints of the city, especially with low-income neighborhoods that were filled with like poverty or whatnot. And we would see what lots were up for grabs, what lots did that entity own because they wanted to put them back to, you know, low-income families. That's what the whole revitalization project was about, make sure that these lots don't get overpriced and get gentrified. So they were really keen on that, like trying. Wow, I'm sorry guys, I took this little red right here, the light switched so fast. All right, how about this, we're gonna go right. Am I correct? Yes, we are in a turning lane, so let's go right. Yeah, so that organization was real fond on trying to get as many properties as they could in their land bank to keep them affordable. And there was a lot that I saw that investors had already took over. And this was like 10 years ago, 9-10 years ago. I've always been pretty involved as a community player ever since I was a kid. A lot of the work I did in my life was, if not free, it was for peanuts. I'm not living a buku lifestyle. I'm still struggling indeed. But you gotta make the best out of the cards you're dealt, right? When life gives you lemons, plant a lemon tree and bake some lemon pie. Give everybody a slice. Okay, we're on 25th and Dolphin. Since it's about to be rush hour, it seems like there's some type of traffic. More traffic than normal, you know what I mean? We're on 25th and Dolphin. We're in the 2300 block of 25th Street. So this is the Strawberry Mansion section. 2500 Dakota Street, that's what we just passed. So I'm gonna try to zigzag. So if you're new to the channel, Philadelphia, the map is set up kind of like a grid. Most streets intersect and they just go left or right and they cross intersect. But in some areas, like you guys saw Sedgley and Glenwood, they were angle blocks. It'll like throw the whole neighborhood out of whack. So I'll just try to cover as many blocks as I could. Check it out, that big building on my right, for rent, storage, shops, church, warehouse, office. That's a awesome building, guys. Wow, it's massive, it's beautiful. It takes up a whole square block. That's a fantastic building, real nice. You can work from it, turn it into a garage, make studios, all types of stuff, living space. All right, let's go straight. See, they painted the building black and white. That's the first time I ever seen one of them factories painted black and white. That's a whole lot of black paint you have to waste to cover that, you know? Has to be some thick pigment. All right. We're at Cumberland, 25th and Cumberland. If we keep going straight, we'll probably hit Lehigh. I'm pretty sure of it. And then we can come back down. Passing Firth, 2500 block of Firth Street. Now we're passing Sergeant, 2500 block of Sergeant Street. We're passing 2500 Huntingdon Street. That's how you pronunciate it. I'm about to like go left, just so we can see some actual houses, because I feel like this street is kind of rushing us out of the neighborhood. That's what I'm saying, you know, you got two choices. you can go to the left access streets, left and right, or you can go to what we're on, like a bunch of up and down access streets. I think in this neighborhood, the up and down access streets get you in and out quick. That's not my goal right now. I'm trying to like casually just cruise through the neighborhood. So right now, the Strawberry Mansion section of Philadelphia, it is a tough area as far as with the news highlights. The news highlights, you know, a lot of crime around here, a lot of shootings, a lot of robberies. It's always usually like young people, sad. Usually young people versus young people. 26 and Lehigh. We have a church on my right. We have two churches. Greater Faith Baptist Ministry. All right, let's let this bus. This is the 54 in front of us, the 54 bus. Thank you, sir. You let us go by. Yeah, most buses don't do that, so that's cool. All right, we're on the 2600 block of Oakdale, passing Oakdale. Oakdale continues on my left, as you can see, but we're going to start going right. Let's see what happens when we go right. Let's not do it yet, because I think that's going to shoot us back to Lehigh. Yep. Let's go down a little bit. Let's take it to, like, Dauphin. Because originally, we wanted to start at, like, Dauphin or, like, Susquehanna. And then go up and down, up and down, up and down. All right, we're at 26 and Huntingdon. These little garages on my right. Looks like they're doing, like, a car wash. They got pressure washer, hose, and all that out there. Oh, look at that dog. The dog looked so cool. 2500 Sergeant Street. And that seems to be an elementary school. No, it actually was in a middle school. That's a high school. What? Name that high school, guys. And we have a nice abandoned building or two on the left-hand side. Prime real estate for investors. Look at that. That's a nice long corner building. The only downside to having a corner building in the city of Philly, especially in North Philly, or in the more rougher areas of Philly, is the graffiti artists tend to like to tag up corner buildings. So if you don't keep your building, you know, nice, keep it clean, you might get tagged on. And sometimes, I hate to say it, even if your building looks nice, they still might tag on it. Another downside with corner buildings is the fact that you can be a victim of an accident. Since you're on the corner, if there's drunk drivers or any, you know, car accidents at the intersection, you can actually get hit. All right, let's see what's happening here. I'm just talking. Let's make a right on Gordon. 2600 block of Gordon. So even though this is, quote unquote, a troubled neighborhood, it's pretty quiet right now. And if you, even if you do see people out, Dauphin was on my left-hand side. Even if you do see people out, everybody's just chilling, minding their own business. Arizona Street. Arizona and York. Parking for North Penn Baptist Church on my left-hand side, and North Penn Baptist Church is on my right-hand side. Will Jesus save you? That's what that sign says. It says Trinity AME Church, Sunday school, 9:15 a.m. Wow, I haven't been to Sunday school since I was a little pipsqueak. I think I go right here so you guys can see the school. I'm sure one of my viewers went here. I'm sure somebody has a great memory here or a bad memory. The school is now abandoned. It looks vacant. Yes, it's absolutely vacant. Unkept, weeds growing through the schoolyard. Let's see. Yeah, sealed up. Yeah, a lot of graffiti on it. They'll end up either rehabilitating that building, turning it into like a senior home or something, or eventually an investor come in, buy it. You guys see this home is two-story houses. This block is two-story houses. Each home has like an apex that connects to the other home. So you got to share that little apex, that little awning per se, right? And then you got like a little porch and you got a basement. Let's go up one more. Most of the people in this area work in class. Yeah, mostly everybody works. We just passed 24th and Cumberland. Somebody on my left-hand side has some Christmas decorations, a wreath. They have a sign that says joy. And that is about it. Not another soul on this block has a Christmas decoration. Nope. One person was in the spirit. All right, we have 23rd and Cumberland in front of us. Let's make this left on 23rd Street. Go to Surgeon Street. Let's make this left on 2300 Surgeon. There, a little corner building. You see? It's a little one-story corner building. It has an air conditioner in it too, so. Person on my left had the handicap ramp. Check out this Passat parked right in front of their house. I'm assuming that's their house if they're parked right on the sidewalk like that. Same thing with this van right up front. They're parked right in front of their house. Check out this little boarded up building on my right. It has a garage, but it has boards on the window. It looks like they're rehabilitating it though. It has new framework and new windows, so they might be just having it closed until they finish the job and then rent it out. Look at this person on my left has their own little, what's that, like a little, I wouldn't call it a yard, but it's like a 2-foot perimeter of a fence going around the house, so you can't get close to the house. I guess, you see, they're smart. They already know that they have a cornered property. So A, the fence pushes people away from, I mean, if a graffiti artist still wants to tag up, they'll have the fence to tag up. But they're less likely to waste their energy. And then if a car accident comes, then it'll hit the gate before it hits the house, providing a little bit of protection. Wow, somebody next to me had a huge snowman. Like one of them air snowmans, the snowman that you could use an air machine and like blow up. It was like an 8-foot, 9-foot snowman. It was pretty cool. All right, guys, so we're on Sergeant. And what are we on? I know we are on a number street. 2500 Sergeant. That means we're on 25th and Sergeant. That's usually how you could tell what number you're next to. You know, 2500 is 25. You know, 2600 is 26th Street. You know, 2700 is 27th Street. That's usually how you can tell. Sometimes there's another block in between it. That's a name. But when it goes back to the number, it's just the next ascending number. All right, here goes that school again. Check out that school. It's huge. It's a very, very huge school. Wow, look at all this dumping right here. That sucks that people just decided that was the spot to dump at. Now, here's the thing with dumping. When it's large amounts like that, sometimes people do this, come out here, because the trash company won't take it. Sometimes if you help them, they'll take it, but they're not supposed to take it. And in order to properly dispose of it, you got to take it to the dump. So you got to have a pickup truck, and you got to pay money too, because they charge you. I believe they scrap it, or they not scrap it. There's another word for it. They recycle it. I think they recycle it based on weight. He goes to the waste yard. They weigh your truck when you drive your pickup truck into the waste yard, or if you got a box truck or whatever you got, when you drive it in, they weigh your truck in, and then when you know, throw it out, then they tell you to get back on the scale and they weigh you out. That's how it is with scrap and metal too. All right, guys, let's turn left because, you know, we got another school over here. I think you guys would appreciate the schools. I know in some of my videos, people go, I used to go to that school when I was a kid. It's pretty cool. Bring back memories. This is called Rudolph Walton Public School. Rudolph's Walton Public School. We're passing 2500 block of Marston. Marston. Not Marl, but Marston. All right, we're on 28th and Huntingdon. 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 That's how it's spelled. It sounds so foreign to me. Even though I've been looking at Huntington since I was a kid, but you hear how I said it? Huntington? Huntington? We're not used to like saying Huntingdon, because there's a D in it. I don't know if the D is silent. Huntington. Huntingdon. All right. We're currently on 28th and Cumberland. 28th and Cumberland. You see that corner building? See how I got graffiti on the doors, graffiti on the windows? That's what I was talking about. And on my left-hand side, that's the corner building. You see those white patches? Those white patches are due to the buff, which is the city's graffiti, you know, graffiti department, where they go, they send people who work for the city out with a truck. It's called clip. I believe that's the correct term. And the graffiti artists call them the buff, but it's called clip. And what that project's supposed to do is they go around all day taking pictures of graffiti. And then after they take the picture to document their work, they basically paint over it. And then they create, I know in LA, they create a file of your name. So I remember I watched a documentary one time in LA. We're on Arizona 28th Street. That's a little plaza in front of me. Best Shop Hairtown and a bunch of other businesses in there. Look at this huge vacant lot next to me. Toilet right in the middle of the street. Yeah, so in LA, I saw a documentary where Clip over there, I think they got their own task force that removes graffiti. Those staff, their job is to take a picture of every tag that they collect, right? And then they'll put it in a database, like on a computer, like on a spreadsheet, and then they'll collect all of your tags. So they'll end up building a file on you. You know, whether your file is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 years long, however long until they catch you, if they catch you. Now, if they catch you and they catch you, let's say your name, for example, is Tito, or we need a better graffiti name, Cheese or something, right? So let's say that's your tag up name, and then they see cheese everywhere, and they got, you know, 700 pictures of cheese over the last 3 years, and they happen to catch you and you get caught writing cheese, they're gonna go, and now they're gonna hold you accountable for all 700 tags that they've accumulated over the last 7 years. They're gonna charge you for that paint, they're gonna charge you for the services, and they're gonna charge you for vandalism, and you'll get a huge case. So yeah, a lot of artists had to change their name, because once they got caught, if that name ever popped up again, they already got you in the database. Yeah, crazy, right? Speaking of graffiti, right in front of us, I see a cess throw up and a Zeebo. I actually know Zeebo. Cess is a Philadelphia legend in my eyes. I seen him at the prime of the 90s, him and ESC, like Kid and all of that. ESC stands for Every Second Counts. That's the Philadelphia Graffiti Squad. And in graffiti, that's the truth. Every second does count. You can't waste no time. All right, let's make a left right here on York Street. I remember seeing that black and white building right there. Let's cross over. Let's see if we can go up a couple blocks, see if we see anything different. Doesn't seem to be much activity out. But then again, we're supposed to get some snow tomorrow. There's supposed to be a big snowstorm this week. With that being said, make sure to turn on the notification bell so you can get notified when I drop a snow tour. Because I'm contemplating when the snowfall drops to do a driving tour, and then I would also like to do a walking tour in the snow. What do you guys think, right? So turn on the notification bell so when that walking tour drops, yeah, you can check it out. I don't know if you guys also see me posting premiere links or the premiere page where it says like in 2 days this video premieres, etc., etc. All you have to do is click that page. You're gonna see like a frozen picture until the video starts. There's a little button on the bottom right hand side that says remind me. If you click that remind me feature, it allows others to know that more people are waiting for it, which helps the video pick up momentum. And then it reminds you. So you don't have to worry about, like, you know, standing around, like, making sure that it's really gonna pop up. Because sometimes it don't remind you. I hear people, they tell me that they don't get my video till the next day. But my video was released yesterday. And say, yo, but it just, look it. Yo, check this out real quick. On my right-hand side, we got a mural of bullet head. Must be a gentleman that passed away here back in the day. Because this is an older painting. Passing 2400 Dover. And then we're passing Checkers on my left-hand side. This box truck right here on my left is selling fruits. It's selling grapes, tomatoes, strawberries. It's selling all types of stuff. I think that was that gentleman right there with the lime yellow. Was it? No, it wasn't him. No, it might be. Yeah, I think it is him. Because he straight up just crossed the street and he's in another vehicle that's directly behind it that looks very similar. So it might be his little stand selling fruits. We're on 29th in York, guys. Let's turn down Hollywood Street. Let's see what Hollywood looks like in Philadelphia. This is a nice little block as far as the uniformity. It's uniform, meaning just about almost all the brick pointing looks the same, same colors. They don't all have porches. You see, some of them do, some of them don't. They don't all have the same color awnings. But for the most part, this block is primarily brick, and then the street is beautiful. Wow, the street, the surface that I'm driving on is smooth. No potholes. Brand new asphalt. That's awesome. See that cat running? Look at the abandoned house on my left. Properties in this neighborhood are going for cheap too. Going real cheap. Be like a $26,000 property, you get another $20,000 property, $16,000 property. You buy it, put a couple bucks into it, you can have a little home away from home for those of you who are gutsy enough to withstand this environment. I mean, I don't see nothing wrong with it, but I get a lot of commenters that go, I will never move to that neighborhood, you know? So I guess beauty is in the eyes of the beholder, to each his own. In my opinion, as long as you have a roof over the head, you're blessed. You live in the home. You don't live outside of the home. So, you know. All right. We see a comment. See on the side of that building on my left-hand side? It says comment. It has a throw up. A throw up is a style of graffiti. It's like a quick bubble letter, and it says comment. NP. NP, when you see it next to graffiti, it means like North Philly. If it's SWP, that's like Southwest Philly. If it's WP, that's, you know, West Philly and so on. I mean, I'm sure you guys can put the rest together, but just giving you a heads up. Comment. Not bad. He has another little marker, little throw up over here on the 2x4 framework that was provided by the city to enclose that lot. Doesn't look bad. That's another thing about Philadelphia graffiti. Not only is it like a language all in its own, like hieroglyphics, but every single body has their own style, just for the most part. Every single graffiti artist has their own style. Some get influenced off of others, and there's some styles that are very similar. For example, Wicked's, you know, majority of Philadelphia graffiti artists know how to do a Wicked, a Tall Hand, you know what I mean, and so on, you know. But there's some people, I have myself, I think I have like 20 hands. I can write tune in about 20 different ways. Yeah, maybe more, but some people have really unique styles. So I can do some of the most common styles. Like I could do a Wicked, could do a Tall Hand, can do a straight, you know, I can do a couple of basic ones. And then I can also do like my own stylization that nobody is doing. I got like a tune hand that both O's turn into I's. Then I do like a heart with like a mouth under it. That's another arrow. I got some pretty cool hands. I'm not heavy, currently active. I dabbled when I was in my younger years, and I was pretty good in, like, you know, black books, pen and paper. I wrote with Krylons, Rust-Oleums, Montanas, and all that stuff. Dollar cans or whatever paint. At the end of the day, whatever paint works. I've even used rollers. Cans, like home paint with a roller. Yeah. All right, so back to the tour, guys. So we're driving through this block up, and we got another double park. That's probably like an Uber.
Uber or Lyft?
Probably mom. Mom and daughter. I don't know why I'm yawning. The cold weather tends to make me sleepy. How many of you like the cold weather? The cold weather knocks me out. Seriously, the cold weather, like, phew. Some people don't like the cold. I embrace the cold. Like, I keep it 100 with y'all. Keep it 100. You want me to keep it 100? Whatever temperature it is outside, it's probably 3, 4, 5 degrees colder when I sleep where I'm at. So if it's 10 degrees outside, I'm probably sleeping in like 8 degree temperature, 5 degree temperature. If it's 5 degrees outside where I'm at, it's probably like negative 2. If I've slept in 0 degree temperature, -1 temperature, you just got to layer up. I think that's why I sympathize with those people that are out there homeless. You know, I've stopped plenty of times, not on camera, and try to like help people. And I've taken sweaters off of my own back. Off of my own back, man. Off of my own back. I remember one time it was early. Oh, let's go forward. Let's check out that block. That block looks brand new. It's called the Oakdale Apartments. I've caught it before, but I've never caught it talking about it. So it's a brand new block. And then we could come back around. Brand new houses. Look at that. And then they got the little Christmas tree in the window. The little, what's that called? Garland. Man, I keep forgetting the name of it. Look at these, got like little front lawns. So I'm assuming this is like low income housing too, like affordable housing. I don't know, you know. Probably, you know, you have to apply and make a certain amount of salary a year. You can't pass a bracket in order to qualify. But I mean, they look good. They don't look that bad. The blue brick and all that stuff, I've seen worse. We have the Widener Branch Library on my left. But yeah, I remember, like, you know, pulling up, and I would see like an old head, like with just a t-shirt, and it's like 12 degrees outside, and I'm in a vehicle, mind you, and he's outside walking and, you know, shivering. And my best friend was African American, right? And I know for sure that he hated the cold. He was a tropical dude. So I seen this older gentleman who was probably in like his 60s, who was African American. And, you know, sometimes they have like mental illness issues or depression, whatever the case may be. They may not be all right. They may be like walking around screaming and cursing, like Tourette's syndrome or something, but I don't care. So I jumped out and I gave him my sweater, and I didn't have like mad sweaters. Like, I don't wear coats. Like, I ain't got coats. Like, man, y'all don't even know. Y'all don't even know, dog. But I embrace the storm and I take it a day at a time, because that's what life is about. Taking it a day at a time. Look at this rehab that they're doing right here. See how they're using cinder blocks to do the face? That's cheaper than doing bricks. Now, how's the insulation? How would everything be after they seal it up? I don't know. But I'm assuming that's probably cheaper than bricks. It's probably cheaper to buy cinder blocks than it is to buy, you know, you can probably buy what? 1,000 cinder blocks versus buying 4,000 or 5,000 bricks. I really don't know how many bricks it takes to build a house, but I'm just making an example. All right, let's go left here. Yeah, but I tend to relate to those people. That's why when some people be like, some comments be extreme. They be like, oh, drop a bomb on the neighborhood and wipe them all out. Or they be like, burn the neighborhood. I'm like, come on, people. Like, that's not the answer. You gotta have empathy for your fellow human being. No one's perfect. I ain't perfect. You ain't perfect. How you gonna sit there and say, blow up a whole neighborhood? Like, there ain't human beings there. In 1985, they tried that at 6221 Osage Avenue when they blew up MOVE. And they leveled a whole square block. All they did was kill 5 adults and kill 4 children. That wasn't that effective. And they left a whole block square homeless. You know what I mean? So sometimes people be radical. They be really, really, really radical with like their energy. And it's like, man, those are energy vampires. Just gotta like stick and move, jab and move, stick and move. Okay, guys, the house is on the left. One, two of them have a porch. Three of them have a porch. The ones on the right have a lot more porches. And they have that apex connection that we were talking about earlier, where like two of them have to share a porch awning. The ones on the left, a lot of them don't have porches. And they got sofas out front. Sometimes you'll see a sofa out front because on the block they use it to chill. Because I know sometimes when we was young, like there'll be a sofa on the block. And when we was like 15, 16, 14, whatever, we would just go out there and hang out and just sit on the sofa. It was a spot to sit on. Sometimes people got them out front because they're waiting for the trash truck to pick them up. See all these refrigerators and this aluminum metal stuff right here? It's tied up. It's strapped up because I don't think he wants anybody to take it. Because, you know, people will end up scrapping it and then trying to, like, make money from it. So they usually tend to do that when they don't want no one to take it. They'll leave a washer out front, but they'll strap it to their house in hopes that no one takes it. They got a grill out front here. Okay, guys, we're on Myrtlewood Street. I'm sorry, I didn't even let you guys know the block. We were on Myrtlewood. Let's make a right here. Now we're on the 2300 block of 30th Street, 30th and York. Let me go straight and then come back around. I'm gonna go straight, right? I'm gonna make a right on, what's this? Corley's. I'm gonna go right on Corley Street. Look at, they got a Panda, Chinese, and American food on my left. These blocks with one side of parking are troublesome. This block got some painted houses. Sometimes people paint the front of the house because it's a lot cheaper. Oh, you see how them cars are hit? That's another bad thing about little blocks like this. Little blocks like this, if somebody's drunk or they're running away or they're in a stolen car, they're just doing something, you know, silly. Sometimes they'll hit you being plain sober. What they'll do is they'll keep going, and they won't, obviously, they ain't gonna wake you up in the middle of the night saying, hey, I hit your car, you know, you want my insurance? No, they keep going. Then you wake up and you got this giant side swipe. This dude right here is, what is he doing, delivery, or that's his home? I don't know. But I slowed down right here so you guys can see the washer and stuff that's leaning right here. Now, this washer doesn't seem to be tied up, nor does this air conditioner. This air conditioner is worth money. The air conditioner is worth about 35 to 40 bucks if you break it down. You have copper, lead, you have the motor, and you have clean, what's that? Is that clean? It's not steel. Not clean iron. It's called clean. I can't think of it right now, but I know you got about three or four different types of metal there that you can scrap. And then the refrigerator is based on weight. That's probably like a good $20 refrigerator, $20, $30 refrigerator. So if you take that refrigerator and that air conditioner right now to the scrapyard and do what I just, oh, and there's a stove, and this all looks like scrap. Yes, and it's actually trash day. So you literally got, let me see, 25 for the refrigerator, about 35 for the air conditioner, and about another 20, 25 for the stove. There's about 80 bucks, 90 bucks of scrap metal sitting out there, depending on where you go. Different scrap yards pay different rate per pound, and it depends if you fully break it down. But yeah, ask me how I know, because I used to recycle products too back in my college days. This older female, she's like probably a grandma. Yeah, she's somebody's grandma. The old folks in the neighborhood are pretty calm and pretty chill, pretty tranquil. Most of the time, if there's any issues, it, you know, it has to do with like the young people. Occasionally, there'll be like an old person that might like be up to drama. You know, one neighborhood usually has that one old head that'll always be starting drama. And it's not the summer, so you guys ain't seeing this neighborhood in its prime. I do have videos coming here with the action camera when I did the Philadelphia Hoods playlist, but I didn't do no narration. So if you're up for watching a silent tour, I got a whole playlist of silent tours. There's plenty of open real estate in this neighborhood. Lots on the left and on the right of me. Lots on top of lots on top of lots. You got the OG out here. We on Stanley Street. Hey, what's up? The OG gave me a piece. Ah, that's what's up. You see, some people chilling, man. You go to some hoods, some people be like real down with it. Like, they be like with it. And the other people, they sit there and they question it. So, you know, I try to do my best to, you know, be as flexible as I can. We have Stanley Rogelio. It's spelled Rogelio, but I believe in Spanish, the G is supposed to be silent. So it's like Rogelio. Rogelio Mini Market. Fresh meat, vegetable, hoagies, frozen food, cold cuts, soda, candy, ice cream, milk, eggs, bread, and more. There's a barbershop on my right, haircuttery. Well, I could have swore I used to go to a haircuttery when I was like 9, like an actual franchise. That's strange. They call themselves haircuttery too. I could have swore I went to a haircuttery when I was like 9 years old. It was like an actual place where you got like haircuts with scissors, and it was females. I would go in and it would be like all women there that were cutting hair. It's back when I was like 9, 10. They used to charge probably like 16, 17 bucks for a cut, which at that time in like 96, 97, that was kind of a lot. You know what I mean? Then the adults would be like 25. Nowadays, kids are 25 and adults are like 50. Yeah. All right. So we are on 31st and Cumberland. We got another beer spot. Cold beer and Chinese food. You can get your General Toast chicken and your beer at the same spot. There's a little playground on my left. I'm gonna see if I go down the little block so you guys can see this little teeny playground that this block has. Check out that corner. See that corner got the handicap ramp? Let's go straight. In front of us, we're gonna hit Lehigh. Then we can come around Lehigh and go down to where that little block had the little playground. So in every block, you might see like 2 or 3 homies just sitting outside and just talking. That's what you do when you're in Philly. We're passing Oakdale Street. Yeah, because sometimes being in a house could be boring. And if you're a busybody, like if you're ADHD, attention deficit disorder, I know I am, because I can't sit still for very long periods of time. Like, I prefer activity. Like, my mind always needs to be stimulated. Like, I mean, I can sit down when I have to, you know, if there's a necessary reason to do it. But what I prefer to do is to be moving around and be active. Like, I'll get up, you know, 4 in the morning, I start moving around, start doing this, be trying to do stuff I should be waiting till the afternoon to do, but I'll do it early in the morning, crack it down. All right, we're on the 2600 block. I didn't even catch the name of this block, but we will learn it together, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this mint house on my left. Some of y'all like that mint chocolate chip, right? Yo, this block is horrible. Look at the street. Whoa! Yo! Seriously, it's like craters. Now this block needs some repair. Holy. What? Oh, snap. Oh. I feel like I'm on a roller coaster. Whoa. Yo, whoever speeds through here does not care about their vehicle at all. Whoever speeds through here doesn't care about their car. Because, yo, this is going to destroy shocks. All your suspension. Oh, man. Your boot joints, your knuckles, your bushings. It's gonna stretch out your whole suspension. Especially if it's a 30-year-old vehicle. Ouch. But then again, don't blame it on the old vehicle, because I got another vehicle that's 47 years old. I got a vehicle from 1973, and that suspension is like you're riding on clouds. you don't feel absolutely nothing. You can take that block that we took, and you could probably take that block smoothly without worrying about bumps. But even if the vehicle can take it, I usually try to, you know, take care of the vehicles. I do my best to take care of vehicles. Look at this little part right here. See it? This is the playground that I was talking about. You guys can see it, but they got a basketball court and a little teeny jungle gym. Yeah, I'm a firm believer that, you know, for example, if you buy a vehicle, make sure you buy a vehicle off of somebody that takes care of it. Don't buy a vehicle off of somebody that abuses it. So ideally, you will want to get, in my opinion, coming from the city, I will want to get a car from the suburbs. I will want to get a car from, like, the farmlands, which is where this came from. This came from Lancaster. But I will want to get a car that was maintained to an extent, you know, that wasn't in a beat-up environment and the owner didn't just, like, you know, mistreat it and abuse it and floor it and burn out and all that stuff. Like, I'm not up for all that. I don't care how old the vehicle is. I will not destroy it. Me and the vehicle become one. Try to take care of it. The longer you take care of it, the more life you have out of it. You know what I mean? Ooh, you heard that? I don't even know if y'all can hear the suspension knocks. Every time I hit a hard bump. I got stock wheels on too, that's a good thing. I had bigger wheels, but they were too big, man. It's not fun riding in all these potholes with huge wheels. Then thin tires, oh no, you're asking for it. We're on Napa Street, Napa. Isn't there something called Napa Auto Parts? Cool, 2400 Napa Street. This is the Associated Supermarket Inc. on my left. All right, we got Patan Street. So let's go up Patan. We got another little local playground. Go figure, and another one across the street. So Strawberry Mansion is loaded with like private miniature playgrounds. We don't have that around our way. Even though we do have parks with playgrounds, but it seems like so far we just passed through 3 or 4 blocks and each teeny little block had its own miniature playground. Like if they didn't want people to leave the block. Crazy, right? All right, check it out, guys, check it out. This house next to us, you could tell it was owned by PHA on my left-hand side. We just passed it a few frames ago. It had the gray PHA metal, I don't know, it's like a window cover that they used to cover the windows of their abandoned property so nobody breaks in. PHA uses that on all their properties. Wow, they got a whole chassis out there. Yo, what's up? Y'all saw that? That was a whole car chassis missing the car body out there in the street. That was crazy. Bathroom, kitchen, flooring, drywall. That must have been an entrepreneur, small business owner, because it's like a private truck with a small number on it. There's also another fine you can get in Philly if you have a vehicle with a large business branding or logo on it or number or advertisement, anything of that nature, and you're not licensed and you don't have a license to have that. You're supposed to have like some type of license code so that if L&I pulls you over, you can show them your license code so they can see that you're registered. If not, you get a fine. I think it's over a certain amount of feet. I think you can't have a sign, like any sign of 1 foot or smaller or something is acceptable. But I think anything over, if you really brand your stuff, like wrap your vehicle with your logo, yeah, you'll get fined if you're not licensed or registered, yeah. All right, we got a lot of corner stores here. Yeah, shootings. All these areas be on the news. Sucks. It sucks, man. I was just watching something earlier. It recommended me about Chicago's area, about how last year, I think 42 children got shot the whole year, right? Well, this year in 2020, in just September, 42 kids got shot in just September. 6 of them passed away. And then, you know, one was like 10 months old, another one was like 2 years old, another one was like 6 years old, another girl was like 9 years old. I'm like, man, they are like taking lives for no reason. The one kid was like 14 and he used to be a rapper, and he had got one to the head. We're passing Arizona Street and now we're passing Gordon. Yeah, the one kid got shot twice and he's fortunate enough to live, so he has to learn how to walk and everything all over again. It was a real sad segment. And you know, he basically wrote a new rap. You know, he still didn't have full function over his legs. He still didn't have full function over his body. We're passing Leslie Picnic Hill. What was that? Leslie Picnic Hill Park High School? We'll reread the sign when we go around the block. But he had to relearn how to walk. He had to relearn everything. And he's still learning his basic locomotive skills. But the part that is horrible was that, well, it's not horrible. I guess it should be, you know, a good thing, but it still sucks that it took him to get shot to realize it. But he wrote a new rap while he was in the hospital bed. You know, he's still recovering. And the new rap consisted of, like, you know, him being cool and all that, that he was a fool or something, and that guns wasn't cool, and now he's, like, gonna focus on, like, getting better, and this isn't a rap, that it's a love letter. I'm like, wow, that's powerful. Like, it took him to get into a tough situation to realize how lucky he was. But sometimes, you know, those people have angels watching over them, and they'll end up becoming prophets. They'll end up, you know, spreading the word of positivity, love, and peace. We got One Bright Ray Community High School on my left-hand side. One Bright Ray Community High School. We're on 31st and Susquehanna. 31st and Susquehanna. Thank you, sir. No dumping, $2,000 fine. Wow, that's an immense fine. And there's still tons and tons and tons of dumping. Man, that's incredible. That's a huge fine. I've always seen 350s. I've never seen a $2,000. $2,000 dumping? Woo, you don't want to get caught dumping around here. See, they had a bunch of chairs and they had a big barbecue grill out there. Yeah, that's how it be in Philly. When you come out in Philly, like in the summertime, you see like 20 little beach chairs outside. You see like the grill. You see the kids playing hula hoops, double dutch. The pump's open. They got little pools out. All right, so this is a two-way street. Strange. A single lane, two-lane street. Wow, on the left-hand side, we got one of the very last few phone booths. You guys see it? It's next to that stop sign. I'm gonna move up a little bit. You see it on the left hand side? You don't see phone booths in urban cities anymore. And that phone booth, the phone is actually missing from the phone booth, but the booth was still there. But you don't see that anymore. Check out these houses on my right. One story, two story, three story, and a fourth story with the attic. And it has an apex top roof. Not to mention, it looks like the basement is big too. So yeah. It might be like a five-story if you hook up the spot, right? Let's turn left here. We're going to turn left on 2100 Stanley Street. Drive carefully. Speed limit is 25. Watch for children. That's why it's important to go slow. Not only for children, but for animals. I can't count how many days I drive around and I see a freshly, you know, hit cat or freshly hit squirrel or freshly hit some type of rodent or animal or something, and that could be easily avoided if you just slow down. You save yourself, you save the people around you, you give the animals a chance. All right, let's make a right here. We're on Ridge Avenue. We're gonna make a right right here. We were already on this avenue, but we just crossed over from Ridge. You remember this school right here? But we made it right. So we're on 31st and Susquehanna. We're gonna keep on going straight. 31st and Susquehanna. Wow, this building on my left-hand side is big. It's a big school, a huge school. It almost looks like a detention center. All right, that block went up too, but it's all right. It looks like it's gonna spin us back around. Passing the 3000 block of Nevada Street. Now we're passing Dauphin. Passing 31st and Dauphin. I wonder if they got a DSP down here, Dauphin Street Posse. Or was that only a Northwest, West Kensington thing? Passing 3100 block of Dakota. Now we're passing the 3100 block of Gordon Street. Wow, there's a rest in peace memorial on my right. You see all them teddy bears? Somebody passed away. It's a shame. Redeemed Baptist Church. Passing Arizona Street. Didn't we see this playground? Yeah, I think we saw this playground. Let's make a left here. It's a little basketball court. Yeah, this was Napa. Remember Napa Street? Remember me talking about Napa? So what we're gonna do is, we went up Patan, didn't we? Go up Patan. Yeah, we went up Patan. This is 32nd Street. There's another basketball court on my right-hand side. I mean, I guess that's cool. Like, I'm happier to see basketball court in this neighborhood versus, I think I did a video like 2 or 3 days ago where in that neighborhood we saw beer distributor. Like, that's a huge bummer. You know what I mean? I think a playground is more empowering than a beer distributor. Look at these houses on my left. They must all be owned by the same entity. Somebody must have bought this whole block. Why I say that? Because all of the front masonry work is exactly the same. The same stylization, similar colors. Yeah. Ouch, potholes. Ouch. Yeah, you really feel it. A lot of dumping, right? For there being a $2,000 fine in this area, there is an immense amount of dumping. All right, Redeemed Baptist Church. That looks very familiar. Okay, it seems like my windows are getting foggy. I don't know if you guys can see, my windows are kind of getting a little foggy. And, cold winter and extreme temps, when I'm doing these tours, I may have to turn on the heater. I don't really want to, because then you guys are gonna hear the vent blowing like right in front of the camera, and it might take away from the video. But in the winter, if I need to do it in order to see, I gotta do what I gotta do. So look at brand new houses on my right hand side, less than a decade old. Let's turn right on Gordon Street. Oh wow, Gordon Street has some nice homes on my right. And then they got some regular homes on my left. The homes on my left are, I guess, older. The ones on my right, you could tell that they was just made recently. Imagine if the whole city looked like on my right. I mean, I guess at one point or another, they got shutters and all. You see that? That's nice. In this neighborhood, that's nice. I'm sorry. It makes the neighborhood look a lot better. They have shutters in Center City, and they have shutters in like Old City, and they got shutters in like Northern Liberties. So for them to have a block or two in Strawberry Mansion with shutters, yeah, it looks cool. It's a little bit more upscale. I don't know what those houses are going for. Brand new house, but you got to take the neighborhood into consideration. Look, they got Christmas decorations. We passed a person or two with some Christmas decorations. Nice little garage. That was a skinny building. The one with the garage on my left, man, it was so skinny. Mazda 626 on my right-hand side has a reputation of having horrible transmissions. Transmissions tend to slip on those things. All right. Ouch. The bus stop, we're on, what's that called, Natrona Street? Ridge and Natrona. We can go left and still explore more of the Strawberry Mansion neighborhood. We didn't cover all of Strawberry Mansion today. If you're new to the channel, I found it that an hour seems to be the sweet spot for tours. I don't want to do them longer than an hour because of retention span issues. You know, a lot of people don't retain. I know I got a short attention span. So sitting for longer than an hour to watch something might be painful for a few. So we're gonna keep this short. We have just reached our 1 hour mark. I wanna say thank you to everyone who has been supporting me with positive comments, with kind words, with words of wisdom, with constructive criticism, with support. If you donated a thumbs up, if you donated a comment, if you shared my video, thank you. It goes a long way. I genuinely appreciate it. Stay tuned for our next tours. Remember, guys, I'm not only doing Philadelphia narrated hood tours or walking tours, but I'm also going to be doing rappers' neighborhoods. So I already did 2 rappers. I still got a couple more rappers, maybe a dozen or 2 more rappers that I want to cover within the neighborhood, or within the city, I should say. So stay tuned for that segment too. Turn on your notification bell. If you don't turn on your notification bell, you won't be notified. All right, guys? Hope you guys have a good day. Stay blessed. And this is Tune. Tuning out.